Yo guys, welcome to RenderRam. My name is Vieco and today I'm going to be covering wood deformations on curved surfaces. And what I mean by that is this. You see these radial thingies? You cannot get these as a texture because these appear only on a specific curve. Well, there is a cheap way in Max how you can achieve that effect, and I'm going to try to elevate it a little bit so that it looks more legit. With that being said, I'm going to be covering two or three versions on how you can achieve this effect. One is abnormally simple. It's going to take you like 5 seconds to do. The other ones take some more work, but yeah, you're gonna see. So this is my result on trying to achieve that effect. As you can see, I got the radial momentums everywhere. Even if I rotate my camera to, I don't know, this thingy, you can kind of see it nicely, you know, it just gives a very cool effect, I think. So I'm gonna try to recreate this kind of like a wooden sofa leg, and I'm gonna be using like a regular, you know, like wooden texture and the bump from that texture, so these two things. Before we start, I just want to state one thing. The higher the resolution of the texture that you use, the better the result is going to be, and you're going to see why. Okay, so for a start, I'm going to add my diffuse texture, plug it into diffuse color, and I'm going to use my bump and plug it into bump. Now, this is where the simple version kicks in. So the only thing that you need to do, add UVW map, make sure you're on planner mode. Let me just zoom out here a little bit. And I'm going to use the resolution or the dimension of the texture, which is 240 times 60 centimeters. So I'm going to type 60 here, 240 here. So one important bit here is to, of course, rotate the texture by 90 degrees or, you know, whatever, just so that you get those vertical kind of wood grains. And we got this result. That's the stupid fast version. So when you add a planar UV, like UVW map onto things, you're actually getting a realistic, you know, kind of behavior of those radial wood grains. As you can see here, you know, like you have like these straight wooden grains, and then as the surface kind of curves, you're starting to get also these curvy momentums everywhere, and you pretty much simulate that effect like this. Now, you can use this method, right? You can use it if you don't have a close-up shot of the object that you are kind of preparing, you know? If this is actually going to be a sofa leg and you're going to be seeing it from like a meter and a half, it's like this much, you can stop here. This is your method. But if you're going to be doing, you know, some more advanced things, then you may want to invest some time in it. Okay, now the problem with that simple version is it's suitable for faraway shots. It's not suitable for close-ups. And the main reason for that is pretty much this. You can see like here, you got this kind of ugly seam. It's obviously caused by the UVW map, and you got these like obviously stretched textures, so it's not really eye appealing. But if you invest some time into a more, let's call it proper texture, you can get rid of those parts, plus you can add additional bits. So you see, for example, these kind of black lines, some pieces of wood, when you cut them on, you know, that curvature, they're gonna have those lines. As you can see here, for example, those lines are like very pronounced. It really depends on the type of wood. On the other hand, some other wood don't have it as pronounced. Like for example, this one, it also actually has it. You can see it here. It's like these lines. But then on the other hand, I took a photo of this wooden leg at home and they're pretty much not visible. So generally do research on your wood. So we are here. First thing that I want to do, I just want to lower down the bump by half. And as you can see here, like you see that, you know, all the effects. Let me actually just put the bump back to one. Look at this. When I remove bump, like the majority of those artifacts are gone. So our main issue that's causing, you know, the ugly seam, etc., is bump. And what I'm planning to do now, I'm planning to somehow procedurally mask only that part with the seam. Why do I say procedurally? Because I'm planning to drag and drop this to a large variety of objects, and I want it to work on all of these objects, right? So I'm gonna right click in my material editor and I'm gonna add fall off. Now, why fall off? So look at this. I'm gonna plug my fall off into self illumination. The reason I'm plugging it into self illumination because I only want to see what the fall off does. So let me just detach my bump for now. And if I go here to the self-illumination render element, you know, I plugged it here, self-illumination is on one. So I'm getting this. As you can see, like when I rotate my scene, the falloff just, you know, behaves like a regular falloff. But what I'm gonna do, I'm gonna go to my falloff direction and get this. If I just switch to my texture, you can see, so here on the left, we got the seam, right? So because of that, in my falloff, I'm gonna set my falloff direction to local X axis. And that local X axis directly targets that seam. So with this falloff, I'm planning to mask out that ugly seam and just replace it with some other texture or something that's gonna work better. Now, before I proceed, there is one issue with this falloff. As you can see, this falloff goes from black all the way to the white, which is here in the center. You know what does that mean? That means that when I apply that as my mask, I'm gonna have my mask effects going from here all the way to the center, where in reality, well, pretty much just this distance, like from here to here, just this distance is my issue. I don't have a problem with all the others. So in that case, in my falloff, I'm gonna enable color map. I'm gonna add a point, let's say here, click on it and set number 1. As you can see, I just kind of stretched out the white area, or the area, you know, of effect. And now I'm just kind of targeting this part. I can just move it maybe a bit to the right, just to kind of increase it, but I think this will work. If not, we're gonna tweak it. Okay, so the black part of the falloff was the one that was, you know, here in the center. So in my falloff, I got the black part, it's this one. That means that I need to plug my fixing texture into that black part, but on the white part, I need to use my regular texture. So I'm just gonna plug this one here, and I'm gonna plug this effect here. And now, as you can see, we generally have the bump here on the front, you know, like you can actually see here. But here on that side, we actually do not have it because we haven't assigned a texture to it yet. So what I'm gonna do, I'm actually gonna right click, copy this UVW map, paste it, and I'm gonna rotate that clone by 90 degrees to here, and I'm gonna set it to be map channel 2. And now I'm gonna clone my bump map here, and I'm gonna set that bump map to be a map channel 2, and I'm gonna plug it into map 1 of the falloff, or that you know, side-facing part of the falloff. And look at this. We got, you know, kind of details here, nothing is stretched, and this whole thing generally works. Now, of course, you can play with, you know, like with the details here, however you want. And this is pretty much me finishing this type of wood kind of part. But now to add those, you know, kind of lines here, I'm actually gonna use a cellular map, and we're gonna need to also do some, you know, blending, masking, etc. to add that cellular map. So I'm gonna grab a fresh new cellular map here. And as usual, I wanna, you know, I'm trying to define those fine kind of lines, etc. And I want to see, you know, like I want to get that effect, you know, right. So now I'm going to go and tweak that cellular map, and I'm also going to plug it to a self-illumination because I want to see exactly just that part, what it does. So plug it here, switch to self-illumination mode, and this is where we're at. So let me just lower my size to be, I don't know, 1 or 0.5, something small. One thing before we kind of proceed, I just want to clone this falloff because again, I just need that effect on the side, not on everything else. So I'm gonna plug my falloff into self-illumination. I'm gonna plug this into map 1, and we are getting this. So this is my kind of effect. Now here, let me just zoom in. I wanna like lower my tiling. So I'm gonna set the tiling to 0.3 just to kind of, you know, straighten it up. Maybe even more, 0.03. Okay, that's better. So we got this effect. Let me see if I turn on fractal. Okay, I'm getting a lot of mess here, but I can kind of, you know, make it more kind of, I don't know, subtle. So let's give it a go like this. And this is it. So this is my kind of mask. So this falloff and this cellular, this, like this as a whole thing, is my mask for all those kind of lines. So now let me just revert back to what I originally had. So what I'm gonna do, I'm gonna add a composite map. So composite, I'm gonna add a second layer, and I'm gonna plug my main texture into layer 2, plug my mask into layer 2 mask. Let me just plug that into the diffuse. You can already see that, you know, these kind of white specks are, you know, starting to appear. I'm gonna add a corona color correct, and gonna plug this here and plug this into layer 1. Okay, now this color correct is gonna be me darkening this part. I don't want to darken it too much, so just, you know, a little bit. Let's say something like, I don't know, this. Okay, yeah, we can nicely see them. See like these blackish kind of parts. Now, to complicate things even more, you know, these lines are usually little bumps. They're like pushed in. They like have a texture, you know? So what I'll do, so this is my bump for the side because it's on the map channel 2. I'm gonna create a mix map. Gonna plug this one into color 2. I'm gonna grab that cellular thing and I'm gonna plug it into mix amount. I didn't plug the falloff and the cellular because there is falloff already here, so there's no need for it. And now I'm just gonna plug that into my map too, and as you can see, that kind of smoothed out all those parts. And from this point, you can just pretty much play with the bump intensity to get these to be deeper and deeper, etc. The only thing that you need to do now, if you want to kind of copy paste this to other objects, you pretty much just need to copy and paste these two UVW maps, paste it to all the other objects in your scene. I literally selected all of these and just paste instance. You see, it's all kind of instances. And this is the effect that you got. Look at this. All of the parts are nicely visible. You got those little, you know, lines there. You got the little radial bits, and it can work for a close-up, not extreme close-up, of course. For that, you need to go and scan the scan the real thing. But yeah, it works for a semi-close-up. And that's it for today, guys. I hope you enjoyed this little kind of tutorial. I hope it helps with your wooden surfaces, and as usual, see you in the next video. Bye.